Hello, everyone. This is a little bit of a different video for me. I used to have a nail blog years ago. I still have it. It's still up, but I haven't updated it in a very long time. But I've had quite a few people question like my nail care routine or ask to see it. What do I do? How do you paint your nails? Things like that. And while my routine has generally stayed very similar to how it was years ago, a few products have changed, and so I thought I'd just give you an updated nail care routine. So first of all, I'm going to talk about everything that I'm using here, and then I'll zoom in so you can actually see what's happening. I have this silicone mat from Uber Chic Beauty, and I like that it's small. It's not real big. I do have a larger version, but this is the small one that I use all the time, and it protects my work surface from any nail polish or nail polish remover. It's absolutely fantastic. If you do not have something that will protect your work surface while you're painting your nails, I highly recommend it, even if it's just, you know, put down like a dinner plate, so that it's something that you can clean off that won't be damaged by any of these polishes or removers that you're going to be using. And also, a tip that I shared with you guys years ago that a lot of you really grabbed onto was when you're painting your nails, make sure that you're working on a very stable surface. I know so many people try to paint their nails while they're sitting on their bed and they've got their hands on their lap, and or, you know, they don't have anything stabilizing underneath their palms or holding anything down. And that's just a recipe for disaster. So if you can, work at a table or a desk. That's what I find easiest. And somewhere with good lighting. That's probably my biggest tip for you. Work on a stable surface. Okay, so cover your surface with that. When you remove your nail polish, I like to use two products in particular. This one is the Zoya Remove Plus. And I absolutely love this stuff. I have been using it for years. And it does have a nail polish remover scent or smell, but it's not as strong as other ones. And the smell is, I mean, I wouldn't say it's pleasant, but it's not awful either. It's pretty good. And it's really gentle on your hands. It doesn't dry out my hands. I have a really good experience with this one. And it comes in this pump bottle. So you can just put a cotton pad on and pump it down, so it's very convenient. And I've had this same bottle for years. I buy the big refill bottles from Zoya directly, and then I just refill this. So that's what I do. By the way, everything that I'm showing you today, I will have a link down below. Okay, so when it comes to removing things, I like to use these cotton pads or these nail pads. And the thing that's fun about these is that they have plastic on one side. Let me zoom in for you. They have plastic on one side, and then it's the cotton on the other. So, and it has this little tab that you can fold up, and then it protects your one hand while you're removing it from the other. So I don't really use the tab so much when I'm working on my fingernails, but when I'm doing my toenails and I want to protect my fingernails, I do use the little tab, and this does prevent any of the remover from getting on my fingers. So these are really nice, and they're very durable, so you can use one pad for multiple nails when you're removing your polish. Okay, after I've removed my polish, I go to the sink, I give my hands a thorough wash, and I use a nail brush to really clean them off. Now you'll notice that my nails are pretty stained. That's because I wear polish all the time. Halfway down the nail, there's no staining. So that's how you know it's polished, because it's growing out. And generally, I do not go naked. So this is a rare moment for y'all. Generally, I don't like to show how stained my nails are, but this is just how it is. This is how it is when you polish your nails. Okay, so after I've washed my hands really well, there is an optional step that I do sometimes, and that is I use a cuticle remover. I'm pretty blessed that I don't have a big cuticle problem, so I only have to use this maybe once a month, maybe every other month. But you just put a little bit of it around the bottom of your nail. By the time you've put them on all 10, then you're ready to go back to the first one, and you can use a cuticle pusher. This one's a metal one. I actually don't prefer to use metal, but this is just what I had on hand here. But you just kind of, you know, push back the cuticles a little bit, and then on all 10 nails, and then go to the sink and wash it off. You don't want to dawdle on this step, because it actually says on the back, let's see, it says, after 15 seconds, push back cuticles, wash excess thoroughly with warm soapy water. It says leave it on calluses for a minute. Apparently that will help too. So anyway, you don't want to leave it on for an excessively long time, but you know, you don't want to go too quickly either. Okay, so after that, now we're going to get into the actual polishing. And I use 5 different products when I'm polishing. This first one is Mavala Scientifique. I don't know. It's a nail hardener. I only use it twice a week. In fact, it even says 1 or 2 applications a week to tips of nails. So this is what I do. Super fast. I just, right on the tips, I make sure I kind of cap the end too. You just want a little bit of this on, and I'm going to zoom in so you can see what's going on. Okay, so I just apply it just to the whites of my nails. Just like that. And I make sure to get my thumb as well. I'm not super precise with this. I just want to get the tip. So I do that to both hands. All right, my next step is Nail Magic. Hope you guys can see that. It's a hardener and conditioner. Like I said before, I will have this linked all down below. And every single step after this is going to include capping the nail. So what I do is I then turn my nail over and I just make sure I get a little bit onto the back. Once again, I'm just coating the nail, flipping it over, and getting the back. If your nails are quite short and you're not able to turn it over and get the back, not a problem. Got some polish there. Try to do as much as you can. After I finish that first initial coat, I'm going to go in with my sticky base coat. I don't even wait for this to dry. I just go straight into it. This is Glisten and Glow base coat. I use the Glisten and Glow top coat as well, which is fantastic. I'll talk about that more when we get to it. But I recently changed it up and started using this base coat, and I love it. So sorry for having it zoomed in and not focusing when I hold things up. I ended up doing manual focus on my camera so that it would stop trying to not focus. And like I said before, I'm going to do the capping of the nail for every single step. And that includes the base coats. These coats are generally fairly clear, so I don't have to be super precise. It can kind of go down onto my cuticles if it needs to or if it wants to. I'm not being super careful at this point. Okay, I finished all 10 nails with the base coat, and I'm going to go straight into the polish color. I'm not waiting for anything to dry. The color I'm using today is Cashmere Crisis from Orly, and when I get ready to use the polish, I like to kind of swirl it in the bottle a little bit, and then when I bring it out, I scrape a little bit off the back of the brush and a lot off the front, and then I go straight into painting. So there's just a little bit of polish on the brush, and I start kind of a little bit away from the cuticle and then kind of bring it down until it's the right distance from my cuticle. Now this brush is shaped so well for my nails. It won't be for everyone's nails, but let's see if I can turn this so you can kind of see a little bit better. Scraping a little bit off the brush. Have just kind of like a little bead there at the bottom. And swipe out. I like to splay the brush bristles so that it extends and pushes out toward the side of my nail. I just grab some more polish and then go at a really slow pace. There's no need to rush this. All right, and I totally forgot. I need to cap my tips by painting a little bit of polish on the back of my nail. So there's just a little bit of polish right there on the back. Going really slow and using the pressure of pressing the brush onto the nail to splay out those bristles. Because you like it, when I put them come down, it kind of spreads them out. That's kind of what you're doing, but on your hand. All right, I'm going to wipe that away. I've completed the first coat on all 10 nails, and now I'm going to do a second coat of the polish. This one needs a second coat to be completely opaque, and even for some polishes that don't need that second coat, I still do it just so I have a really nice, even surface of polish. I also do not cap the nails again on this step. I just do a regular coat. I'm going to kind of rotate my fingers a little bit so I can get that brush in there better. Okay, I've now painted all 10 of my nails, and now it's time to do some cleanup. I clean up around the cuticles before I do a top coat, and I just use some straight acetone. This is just some acetone that I put into a little container, and I'm going to use a small nail brush. It's actually not a nail brush. It's an eyebrow brush from Sephora. Yeah, it's just an angled brush. Looks like that. And I dip it into the acetone, and then I can go around my cuticles if they need any cleanup. Thankfully, this polish doesn't really show any strange spots a whole lot. Right here, there's some little weirdness, so I'm going to just swipe the brush with acetone over that area, and that cleans it up just a little bit. Now, the thumb on my right hand is always one that I have issues with, so I do have to do quite a bit of cleanup on this one just to get that bottom line nice and smooth. Perfect. We're now on to the very last step. This is Glisten and Glow Top Coat. This is a very fast drying top coat, and I don't think I would paint my nails as often if it weren't for this top coat, because it is fantastic. It's better than Sèche-Vite, which is one that I shared with you guys before. It doesn't dry out as quick. It doesn't get gloppy. It settles. It's perfect. I love it so much. Okay, so, and it also has refill bottles if you need to keep the same bottle but just refill it. And I like to have quite a big bead of the polish on the brush and then spread it out over the entire surface of the nail. You're going to want to make sure that you cap it on the other side, and that's really going to seal in all of that polish. Once again, a kind of a bigger glop of polish so that it has a lot of polish to really spread around. And my brush is quite flat against my nail. That helps preventing any of the colored polish from being picked up by the top coat brush. By the way, I did not stop and wait for anything to dry during any of this manicure. By the time I finish my 10 nails, I can move on to the next step. I want to say from start to finish, I can probably have my nails painted in 15 to 20 minutes. I'm really not careful about trying to make thin coats on the top coat because it's self-leveling. It'll level out to a beautiful glossy shine. So I don't mind having it be a little bit thicker. Okay, so there is my updated manicure routine from beginning to end. Sometimes after my nail polish is dry, I'll go around and add a little bit of cuticle oil. But really, it's a lot about hand cream. Make sure that the skin is moisturized and it continues to look great. By the way, this top coat is dry to the touch after about 10 minutes. And then it's completely dried all the way through. I would say maybe about 30 to 40. So you're good to go. But one way you can tell if your nail polish is completely dry is you kind of tap the nails together like this. I'm not going to do it since mine are still wet, but tap them together And if they have a little bit of stick to them still, even though you're not like marring the polish, that means they're not completely dried all the way through. So, you know, maybe an hour or two later after I finish painting, I'll do that little tap test to make sure that it's completely dry. And if it's completely, completely dry, then I'm free to go about my business. So, hope that tip helps you with your top coats. And try out this top coat. I mean, I'm seriously, it's life-changing. And I think the combination of their base coat and top coat is just phenomenal. I mostly get about 4 to 5 days without any chipping. And one time I got all the way into like 7 or 8 days. So it really just depends probably on what polish you're using. And, you know, there's so many different environmental factors that could go into this. But I really think this is kind of like a magical combination, these two together. So take it for what it's worth. Thanks so much for watching today. Like I mentioned before, I will have all the products I've used in this video listed down below, including this Orly polish. I like to purchase from a lot of different places online when it comes to nail polish. Directly from the polish company is probably always best, but I think I picked this one up at Trans Design. I really like to get Orly polishes there, and they're super fast with shipping, and the prices can't be beat. Thanks so much for watching today. I'll catch you guys in another video very soon.